Hey, Nat.
Hey, lady. That interview you did with Piper is really selling. Here's your free copy.
We got small arms. Long arms, ammunition.
Swaz, right here. Let's go. Bashes in the Commonwealth.
Hairstyles from the upper stands.
Noodles are the official eats of Diamond City. You should try some.
Beat it, lady.
Hey.
What's your problem?
Why are you bothering Travis?
Why are you getting involved in something that don't matter to you? Now get the hell out of here.
Hey.
What's your problem?
You're the problem, pal.
You're sticking your nose someplace it don't belong. Best stay out of it. Now get the hell out of here.
Mm-hmm. Hey.
What's your problem?
Looks like you're having a disagreement.
Look at the smart guy we got here. Except, if you really were smart, you'd take a hike right about now. Now get the hell out of here.
Hey.
What's your problem?
I'd like you to leave Travis alone.
Yeah, well, I'd like a million caps. Looks like both of us are gonna be disappointed today. Now get the hell out of here.
Hey there, pal.
Oh, it's you.
Well, this whole situation looks like trouble.
I didn't start this. I have no idea what I did to deserve this. I just wish they'd go away.
Why not stand up to him?
No, I mean, no. That would be bad. With these men, it could turn violent.
Don't you want this to stop?
Yes, but...
Nothing will change unless you make it happen.
It's not that bad. I can just deal with this.
Don't worry. I've got your back.
Well, if you think it would work...
We're right behind you.
Okay, that's enough.
Oh, I'm sorry. You say something.
I said that's enough. Leave me alone.
Look at you. Let me think about that for a second. Nah, I don't think so.
I mean it. Leave me alone!
Sounds like you were thinking about saying, or else. Were you, Travis? Were you gonna say, or else? I'm wondering what comes after that. What you gonna do, little man?
I'll beat you up!
Big mistake, Travis. I'm gonna destroy you and your friend here.
Travis.
Oh, jeez.
I am so, so sorry. I mean, I don't want to say I told you, but I kind of told you it'd end up like this.
So, how was your first fist bite? You have fun?
Not really, no. But, I mean, I guess, you know, I'm still alive. It wasn't the end of the world. I'm gonna go now, but, thanks. Thanks for, you know, sticking up for me.
Vadim.
Okay, not quite what I expected, but we move on. Ready for next part of foolproof plan?
It's not more fighting, is it?
No. This part is simple. You have seen Scarlet, yes? She has worked here for some time. Now, I am just simple bartender, but I see things. I see how Travis looks at her, and I see that sometimes she looks at him. If someone who was not her employer suggests that she go spend time with Travis, it might do him some good.
Oh, that'll totally boost his confidence. You know, as long as it doesn't backfire horribly.
So little faith. It will work. Trust me. Just do whatever it takes to get her to agree to see Travis, and this will all be worth it. And you and I never talked about this, all right?
afraid. We're always open. We're so delighted you've chosen us for your shopping needs. We buy and sell everything. From everyone. Always.
What do you sell here?
Everything, Mum. Miss Myrna prizes herself on being a collector of quality odds and ends from all over the Commonwealth. We also buy any unwanted items you may be carrying on your person. And we're open 24 hours a day.
Let's see what you got.
Here you are.
Never eat just one. The best in talk, sports, drama, and music, Atomic Radio.
Coming to a theater near you, Dick Patty and the drag strip Dolly. He's the man behind the wheel with grease in his hair and lead in his foot. She's his arch rival with a
Hey.
Point the way.
Hey, Piper.
You sure manage to find your fair share of trouble, don't you?
It usually finds me.
Hey, I'm not one to judge. Honestly, it's just nice to not be doing it alone for a change. In my line of work, things tend to get pretty hairy. I've been shot at, poisoned, nearly executed. Heck, until recently they called the lockup in Diamond City the Piper Suite. Anything for a story, I suppose.
Someone poisoned you?
Are you kidding me? I barely had the paper going before I got poisoned. First time, I'd just published an article about this cartel of caravans that had been driving up food prices in the city. Article went over well, even got a boycott of their goods started in town, so I figured I'd pop over to the Dugout Inn for a victory drink. I'd already taken a swig by the time I realized something was wrong. Vadim, he wasn't at the bar. The beer tasted off, even more so than usual. And I started feeling real woozy. I don't know what he slipped me, but I knew I had to get it out. I'm looking around for something, and there it is, the still, and I just start chugging moonshine. Honestly, I'm still not totally convinced it was better than just dying from the poison, but it worked. And while I was passed out on the floor, security managed to grab the bartender. He eventually ratted out his bosses, and they all got to share some time in the pen.
Seems that execution didn't quite take, huh?
Thank God. I'd been working on this story about irradiated drinking water in Bunker Hill. I traced the water back to its source through these old sewer tunnels, and what do I find? The Children of Adam, setting up like they own the place. Unfortunately, they found me just as quick. Turns out they were not fond of reporters. So, to atone for my trespassing, they decided to make a sacrifice to Adam. Me. I'm kneeling there, about to get the boot into this huge sewer pipe, when suddenly I blurt out, "Adam! He reveals himself!" And they buy it. They pull me back from the ledge, and then gave me their induction ceremony. You are looking at an official acolyte of Adam. Took me a couple more days before I managed to sneak away, get Bunker Hill security to finally clean the place up.
You've led an exciting life.
Sure have. But honestly, now that I'm out here with you, I feel like I'm just getting started. Getting in trouble is what folks like us do. I mean, you and I are out here putting ourselves at risk so people in the Commonwealth can have a chance at a better life. Not for praise or reward or glory, but because it's right. I just wanted to let you know. I'm real happy to be along for the ride.
I'm glad you're here too, Piper.
Thanks, Blue. That means a lot coming from you. So, you want to get out of here?
Heads up.
Just
come on. Heads up. Moving out.
So, you're not an idiot.
Thanks, I guess.
No, I didn't mean like... I could just use some help. This isn't the sort of thing I'd normally bother anyone else with, but you just seem really good with people, and I've got this issue with my sister, Nat, becoming me.
Becoming you? What do you mean?
I'm just terrified she's gonna start taking up like her big sis.
I mean, think about the life we lead. No offense intended, Blue, but personal safety doesn't exactly seem like either of our strong suits. I can't have her ending up like her big sister, dodging bullets and running from all the people she pisses off. It's part of the reason I'm on the road so much. Part of the reason I'm here with you. I keep thinking, maybe if I make myself scarce, if I'm not around her enough, she'll cool off. She'll just go back to being sweet, innocent Nat, paper girl, an all-around upstanding citizen. What do I do, Blue?
You just love her. Family's precious. The last thing you want to do is drive them away, because you might lose them forever.
You're right. I can't risk that. Thanks, Blue. Who'd expect wandering off with a stranger to turn out this well? They really don't make them like you anymore. You're a hell of a friend, you know that?
The feeling's mutual, Piper.
Ain't that the truth? But hey, thanks again for listening. It's a real weight off my chest to be able to talk it out with someone. So, you wanna hit the road?
Arturo.
Got some great stuff, if you're interested.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Everything hand-tooled.
Doc.
We offer a wide variety of medical treatments.
Patch me up, Doc.
What's feeling off today? What can you tell me?
I'm pretty beat up.
Scrapes and bruises. But it's probably a good idea to get them fixed up. All done. Any other complaints?
Neighbor, huh? You looking to get stoned or stabbed?
Yourself into trouble again, Nell?
What can I say? I learn from the best.
I'm flattered.
So, what's the deal with the new girl?
All right, we're all here. Mel, you want to introduce your little friend?
Yep. Meet Sonya. This little bot is going to help us move through the earth like a mole rat on jet.
Because a robot with no limbs is exactly what you want for your digging operation.
What did you expect? A Mr. Handy with a shovel? She's one of a kind. I modified her radio systems to emit sonic pulses at frequencies that can loosen any sediment around.
Mel says we'll be able to get to the strong room 10 times faster than just digging. And it's a hell of a lot safer than loading this place up with dynamite.
All right, guys, get ready. I'm not completely sure how this place will respond. So, brace yourselves. Sonya, do your thing.
Came right up to my door and took the job. She takes orders and she's useful in a fight. What more could I want?
She seems to have a good head on her shoulders. Maybe we don't burn bridges this time. Yeah?
Bobby.
Just find a way for us to move forward. Remember, Southwest is best.
Of all the ways to make caps, Why this?
It may be more personal than I let on. Let's just say I have beef with the mayor. Thinks he can keep Bobby No-Nos on the sidelines. But forget all about that. We have a job to do.
Mel.
If you find anywhere you want Sonya to blast, give me a shout.
What's the story with you and Bobby?
Well, she swears she used to work with my grandfather when he was about my age. She courted me at the bar in Good Neighbor and kept telling me how I looked just like her dead friend.
Yeah, and she was also my great-aunt's neighbor's pharmacist.
Yeah, well, laugh all you want. I didn't care if it was true. I was just glad to get to do something with my life. I've been working with Bobby ever since, and only regretted it occasionally.
We need to get through here, Mel.
Got it. Sonya, blast time.
Time for some news.
Now we're going to get to
it. Oh. Oh. The same
thing has come to that. The
truth is better.
We need Sonya here.
No problem. Come on, Sonya.
Mel, get Sonya over here.
Gotcha. Sonya.
Bobby.
Just for us to move forward, remember, Southwest is best.
Looks like a subway tunnel.
And we're on the right track.
I see what you did there.
What? No. Just keep heading southwest. We need to find a place to blast out of these tunnels.
Over here, Mel.
Sonya, you know what to do. How come it's been so long since we worked together, Barton?
I've been trying to keep a low profile on this one now. And I didn't want to get you wrapped up in it unless I had to.
We've been through worse jobs than this.
We're not done yet, are we?
Encouraging.
Off my face, but you two might want to watch out for the radiation around here.
The thing on this one's wrist has a Geiger counter equipped. I'll just keep my ears open for clicks. I don't want to nerd out over it, but a Robco Pip-Boy is a rare find, my friend. You're gonna have to let me play with it later.
Mel, get Sonya over here.
Got it. Sonya, blast time. Here we go
how I go.
I knew I heard something.
And that's all you got?
Who's there? There you are.
Ha!
We need to get through here, Mel.
Gotcha. Sonya.
And, there are... Want some people help you stay in the air? People like, Power noodles. Our chef only says one sentence, but that's okay, because he only serves one thing. Are you a pistol-packing mama? If you are, the song is about you.
Looks like this place was run by Mr. Handy. I can fix one up. All right. We'll take it.
Over here, Mel.
No problem. Come on, Sonya.
Let's go. That's all you've got.
Yeah.
We're getting really close. There's a brewery near
the corner. We did it! You're zombies!
This has to be the basement of that brewery.
What did you say?
Mel, no.
Just kidding.
We need to get through here, Mel.
No problem. Come on, Sonya.
Well, if anyone could figure out a good use for it...
Mel.
I knew we'd be digging, but I didn't think there would be this much fighting.
Good work on the robot. Very helpful.
Thanks. You know, iBots like Sonya aren't easy to come by. She just floated right across my path one day, blasting those horrifying old emergency broadcast announcements. Like it was fate or something.
Bobby.
Getting closer.
You're not doing anything to help.
I am paying you to do a job. You don't like it, you can leave.
Mel.
If Bobby's directions are correct, and I have my doubts, the strong room should be right through there. If you had anything else you wanted to check out in this tunnel, I suggest you do that first.
Doubts?
It just doesn't seem like we're under Diamond City, does it? I don't think Bobby's telling us everything about this job.
Up to you.
I say we keep moving. Ready, Sonya?
Bobby.
Great. Now my socks are wet. Well, guys, we're right under the Diamond City strong room.
You sure this is the right place? I've been mapping it out, and I think Diamond City should be a little further north of here.
I don't have a doubt in my mind. How about a little trust for the boss?
Tell the truth, Bobby. Where are we?
Under the Diamond City strong room. And that is the last time I'm saying it. We still need a way to get up there, though. Mel, you think your robot will work here?
Look at this place. The foundation is already crumbling. One blast from Sonya, and I bet the floor above will come right down.
Well, then make it so.
He won't want to be in the room for this collapsing foundation and all.
Good thinking.
All right, then. Everybody clear out. Sonya, prepare yourself for a blast at maximum power. Here we go! That didn't sound good. Sounds okay.
Now let's get up into that strong room, shall we?
No, no, no! Sonya!
Pull yourself together, Mel. We don't need that thing anymore anyway.
But...
You can make another robot with the haul we get from the strong room. Keep your head in the game.
you doing here?
Shit.
You seriously didn't think Hancock would catch wind of your scheme? He took you in, Bobby. And you're stealing from him?
Don't listen to her.
What does this have to do with Hancock?
Yeah, about that. As Mel guessed, this isn't the Diamond City strong room.
I see the rest of you are in the dark about this. Nice, no-nos. You all just broke into Hancock's storeroom. You know, Hancock, the mayor of Good Neighbor.
Damn it, Bobby.
Listen, guys, I know this isn't what you expected, but there are still a ton of caps on the line here. Help me take her out, and all of it is ours.
This is Hancock we're ripping off here. The guy tends to hold grudges.
Counteroffer. Just go back into your tunnel, and we can forget this ever happened. What do you say?
What is this about, Bobby? Why did you lie to us?
I knew no one in their right mind would help me rip off Hancock. Everyone is so damn afraid of him, is so damn in love with him. He thinks he is invincible. I wanted to show him he wasn't.
Come on, Bobby. At least if we leave now, we leave with our lives.
Well, shit. You're right. I'm not one to give up. But I know when I'm outmatched. Let's go.
Thank God. I don't know why I trusted you again, Bobby. But that was the last time.
You'll get over it. Now let's split before the girl changes her mind.
What a waste of time.
Hi.
You made the right move.
How did you find us?
If you think Hancock doesn't know about everything that happens in his territory, you're mistaken. You have to know you guys weren't exactly silent down there.
Bobby lied to us. I'm glad it shook out this way.
I was itching for a fight. But I guess this works too. Here, take this. A token. For doing the right thing. Hancock will be happy to hear about your loyalty. You should go pay your respects. In person. It's best to stay on Hancock's good side. Trust me.